And joining us on Hot Copy this morning, we have the lawyer of Pastor Apollo Quiboloy, Attorney Israelito Torreon. Attorney Torreon, good morning to you.
Good morning, Ma'am Karen, and good morning to all watchers of this program.
All right. Is Pastor Apollo Quiboloy still in the Philippines?
Well, I can say that he is still in the Philippine territory, yes.
What does Philippine territory mean to you?
Well, within the country, of course.
Okay, so he's in the Philippines.
Yes, yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Oh, kasi Philippine territory, ang laki niyan, West Philippine Sea, hanggang doon. So is he in the Philippines?
He is still in the Philippines. If you note, he had a declaration and he requested only the Philippine government that there shall be a promise in writing that President Marcos, Justice Secretary Remulla, the PNP chief, the NBI director, that Washington won't interfere in court proceedings here in the Philippines. And I believe that is not an unreasonable request. And he merely wants an assurance that he will not be extraordinarily rendered to the United States of America, which is different from extradition, Ma'am Karen.
Okay, explain the difference.
Well, the difference is that in extraordinary rendition, this is the illegal practice by the United States of America, which was done as early as 1866 until the present, where the United States of America would illegally, extra-legally kidnap certain personalities and bring them to countries and to territories called black sites in order to conduct torture or interrogation techniques, which they call waterboarding and the like, in order to secure information or for other purposes, ma'am. If you remember the killing of Abraham Lincoln, suspect there, John Surratt, in 1866, he was extraordinarily kidnapped in Egypt at that time and brought to the United States of America. And other subsequent cases, recent cases, like the Abu Omar case, the Al-Nishari case, and other cases. So this is the legitimate fear of Pastor Apollo C. Quiboloy.
So Pastor Quiboloy's fear is essentially intervention or interference from the United States, correct?
Yes, yes, okay. Yes. He simply wants an assurance that there shall be no interference on the part of the United States of America, which is a valid request pursuant to the ICJ case, Nicaragua versus U.S., which is a principle of non-intervention. He simply wants that.
Okay. Now, Secretary Crispin Remulla has said that he should surrender without conditions.
Well, that's, of course, he is the Justice Secretary, and we understand that. But if you come to analyze the request of Pastor Apollo C. Quiboloy, he is merely a citizen who is asserting his right that the United States of America should not intervene in the judicial proceedings in the Philippines. This is pursuant to the social contract theory of our government, upon which the United States of America is founded upon, and the Philippines likewise. We surrender some of our rights to the government. In return, the government should protect us. Protect us from what? From foreign interference. That is an age-old doctrine upon which any Republican government is founded upon. Social contract theory. Yes.
Now, attorney, if the government does not grant this assurance, what makes of Pastor Apollo Quiboloy?
Ma'am Karen, he is an accused now indeed because of the warrant of arrest that was issued against him. But remember, the preliminary investigation before the DOJ transpired for more than 4 years. And according to Tatad versus Sandigan Bayan, Kagang versus Sandigan Bayan, Katamco versus Sandigan Bayan, and the latest case which I handled also, Peñas versus Comelec, which led to the dismissal of more than 1,000 cases. They violated the right of the accused to speedy disposition of cases, and this is still pending because we filed a motion for reconsideration in the DOJ, and we argued that you allowed the 4 years, more than 4 years, for the complainant to prove his case, and that all of the cases were already dismissed in the DOJ of Davao City 2 times. And this has been pending in the DOJ for more than 3 years. So we actually invoked that in the Department of Justice, and today we will file a motion to quash warrant of arrest before the Regional Trial Court of Davao City, because right to speedy disposition of case is a substantive right and it is a protected right under the 1987 Constitution, aside from him being innocent of the charges against him.
Okay, let's start first with this. You talk about 4 years, right?
Yes, sir.
Four years. Ma'am. But we have to remember that in the last 4 years, in the last maybe three of the four, Pastor Apollo Quiboloy was very close to former President Duterte. Of course, the cases won't move.
Well, no, that's not a reason because the DOJ can always resolve it. As a matter of fact, we filed motions for early resolution. Whatever may be the reasons for DOJ not to act is beyond us. And it is the bounden duty of Department of Justice to speedily resolve cases before it. That's not the reason on, I think, in my humble view po, Ma'am Karen.
Okay. Another issue is the DOJ states that in this particular case, the 17-year-old victim alleges a series of abuses that started in 2011 and included a rape in 2014 of September. Does this 17-year-old also factor in or fare in the previous case?
Ma'am, you have to know that this 17-year-old was earlier filed cyber libel cases as early as 2018. There were warrants of arrest that were issued against him by the Regional Trial Court of Panabo City in 2018. Suddenly, she filed by way of countercharge in 2019, specifically December 18 of 2019, for four cases, one of which was rape, for a crime that happened as early as September 1 of 2014, 5 years thereafter. There were no police reports, no medical reports. She even did not report the matter to her own sister, who was also studying with her in JMC. She did not even report the matter to her own father, who was present during that time. And the selection of date was even very doubtful, because at the date that she chose was that she was allegedly 17-year-old, and we have reasons to suspect that she chose that date so that she would qualify as a minor. And these matters were fully discussed by the city prosecutor's office, and there were even five prosecutors who studied the case and dismissed the case, and she filed a motion for reconsideration, and the same was likewise denied. So all of these matters should have been a closed case on the part of Pastor Apollo C. Quiboloy, and being revived at that time as if there was an orchestra, a maestro playing an orchestra against him, you should please give him some leeway. Imagine the disappointment being felt by Pastor Apollo C. Quiboloy.
Okay. Well, attorney, I don't feel any sympathy for Pastor Apollo Quiboloy. And I don't think the Filipino people should either, considering he's a very powerful man. That's number one. Number two, on the case of rape that it's reported late, let me tell you that women don't need to admit they've been raped immediately. That's been proven. They don't tell their father, their mother, or their siblings. But that's not a reason to believe that the rape didn't actually happen. And regardless of a reported rape 5 or 6 years after the event, that's still a valid case.
Ma'am, we understand that. And I don't have anything against women. My wife is a very beautiful woman. And of course, she is a woman. But the fact that Pastor Apollo C. Quiboloy may be influential, he may be rich, that does not mean that he has no rights under the law. And his rights should likewise be protected. What is good for the gander should likewise be good for the
youth. I agree with you. But are you telling me that these witnesses who have attended the Senate hearings are all lying?
The Senate hearing is another matter.
Are you believing, honestly speaking, right now?
The Senate hearing is handled by another lawyer.
In the United States, for example, there is evidence of Pastor Apollo Quiboloy child trafficking. Do you honestly believe that he is innocent?
Yes, ma'am. I am assisting likewise there in my own humble capacity, because I cannot.
So why would these women lie?
Well,
why would they lie?
I think you know, ma'am, that I would be competent to know what are in the minds of the women,
because why would women lie?
Who would know what is in their minds? What I know, ma'am, is like this. These women were former members of Pastor Apollo C. Quiboloy, and the fact remains is that all of their allegations have already been debunked. And the only woman who filed the case against Pastor Apollo C. Quiboloy is Blenda C. Portugal. And his allegations were already debunked by the City Prosecution's Office and the Department of Justice, for lack of a better word, sat on the case for many years. And this was only revived at the time when Senator Risa Hontiveros was already investigating the United States of America. And as a matter of fact, as you know, there is already a warrant of arrest. We feel, ma'am, that all of this, according to Pastor Apollo C. Quiboloy, there might be a reason why there was a warrant of arrest that was issued against him aside from his absence. There is a reasonable ground to believe that okay. A guy's extradition may be in play, that an informal surrender may be in play.
All right, attorney, I get your point. He doesn't want to be extradited. He doesn't want U.S. intervention. You've made that clear. I think the question here is this. Why would this woman make up a story? Just give me a reason.
Ma'am, because before she left the kingdom, there were already a viral video that was posted on Facebook of her being placed in a very scandalous position, which she gave to her own boyfriend, but she leaked it. And there was also a libel cases that were filed against her. Maybe, I can only suppose, because you want me to speak for her, I cannot know what is in her mind. I'm not Nostradamus. Maybe this is a way for her to strike back against Pastor Apollo C. Quiboloy. And maybe those forces behind Pastor Apollo C. Quiboloy contacted him to bring up trumped up charges against Pastor Apollo C. Quiboloy so as to get back at Pastor Apollo C. Quiboloy. The possibilities are endless, ma'am. And okay. I am not
so
in a capacity
you believe,
to say what
attorney,
is in her mind.
Attorney, you believe the FBI would make trumped up charges?
The FBI, the charges are filed by individual persons who were former members of Pastor Apollo C. Quiboloy, who may have...
I agree, but there are similar accusations, right?
The FBI cannot make
allegations.
The FBI cannot make trump-up charges because they are merely authorities who would enforce their laws. I cannot fault them. But the fact remains is that there are trumped-up charges filed against Pastor Apollo C. Quiboloy, and FBI has been made an instrument to perpetuate injustice against my client. That is the point, ma'am. As a matter of fact, Pastor Apollo C. Quiboloy may not be totally against an extradition process. What he fears is the extra-legal, illegal practice of extraordinary rendition, which happened to Kerr, which happened to Fresby, which happened to Humberto Alvarez McCain, which happened to Elmasri. Elmasri was a cleric.
All right. You make it clear. Made it clear. So now you're saying he's open to extradition.
Maybe. He may be open to extradition because it's a full process. But I cannot state for certain if he will agree with me. In my previous discussion with him, well, if extradition, maybe, but extraordinary rendition, totally no, because that is illegal. That would constitute a violation to our territorial sovereignty and independence of the
Republic.
All right,
attorney, I agree with you on that. Mm-mm. I agree with you on
Thank
that.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
No
Thank
U.S. you intervention, but extradition. That's allowed by law.
That's allowed by treaty.
Okay, so let's move on. Mm-hmm. Let's move on. Mm-hmm. If he is innocent, why won't he just attend the Senate hearing? An ordinary Filipino doesn't have this kind of leeway.
That is why, precisely,
why doesn't he just attend?
If you have just read and analyzed his declarations, he wanted that the Philippines would not interfere in judicial proceedings, as well as assure him that he will not be extraordinarily rendered. Have you heard about Ramzi Ahmed Yusef?
Wait, Ramzi Ahmed attorney, Yusef, ma'am, attorney, we are going back. Mm-hmm. We are going back to your issues. I get it. But the point is this. Are you telling me that Pastor Apollo Quiboloy would rather remain a fugitive than attend a Senate hearing?
No, ma'am, that he has still remedies under the law. The charge against him is still under question. We still have a motion for reconsideration before the DOJ, and I am filing today a motion to quash the warrant of arrest. If the warrant of arrest would be rendered void because the information is void, because the resolution is void, why is it void? Because it violated his right to speedy disposition of cases, so there is no arrest against him. He cannot be classified fully yet as a fugitive from justice because the charge against him is still under question, and it is one of his rights under the law. You could not fault him. I could not force him because that is his personal decision.
Absolutely.
That's his personal decision.
Well, number one, I cannot fault him for having a lawyer who's doing his job.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you very much. I have to do my job.
Okay, number two. But what makes you optimistic that the local courts will quash the warrant of arrest, considering he has a warrant?
Well, I am a
United
positive.
States too. In other words, in the US, he has a warrant. What makes you think that the local court will quash the warrant here?
Because I am a positive man, ma'am, because of jurisprudence, because of Kagang versus Sandigan Bayan, Tatad versus Sandigan Bayan, Duterte versus Sandigan Bayan, because of Katamco versus Sandigan Bayan, because of Joseph Peñas versus Comelec. It is based on our jurisprudence that if you violate the rights of an individual to his right against speedy disposition of cases, the information is void and the warrant of arrest is void. What makes me optimistic? Simply because I'm a lawyer, I'm a law dean, and therefore, since the Supreme Court has already decided that way, then therefore, res judicata would dictate to me that similar cases, just like Pastor Apollo Quiboloy, would be decided in the same way. Tatad versus Sandigan Bayan, the delay was not even 3 years. In this case, ma'am, 4 years and 2 months is the delay. So therefore, I have reasonable grounds to believe that if this case will reach the Supreme Court ultimately, it may be denied in the regional trial court. We will go to the Court of Appeals, and the Court of Appeals may side us, ma'am. Side with us, rather.
Okay. Now, on that note, I think at the end of the day, moving forward, you will file a case. But what does Pastor Apollo Quiboloy plan to do? He's just going to remain in hiding.
He already declared his... some may not like the word that he demanded, but actually there is legal basis to it because that's pursuant to the social contract theory. But he still has remedies under the law, as what I have already told you. And it is within his personal right to decide whether or not to face the case or not. A similar case can even be cited. I think Senator Lacson likewise faced the same situation in the past. And the resolution against him was declared as... his case was dismissed in the Court of Appeals for lack of probable cause. There are other cases likewise in the past whose probable cause was found not to be present by the Court of Appeals and even the Supreme Court. So perhaps, I cannot speculate, this is one also of the remedies that are being expected by Pastor Apollo Quiboloy, so that his innocence can be proven without him actually surrendering. It's his option, ma'am.
Mm-hmm. On that note, thank you so much for joining me today, Attorney Israelito Torreon. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.